Supreme Court delivered its landmark judgment ruling privacy as a fundamental right, but the lack of clarity about the legal framework still persists. Ashmit Kumar caught up with Ajay Bhushan Pandey, the CEO of UIDAI. Pandey told Ashmit that when it comes to the Aadhaar number, one should be rest assured that the number won't be misused. He has, however, cautioned that one should not upload personal information on social platforms unnecessarily.
We issued an advisory saying that the people should not put their personal information, such as Aadhaar, unnecessarily on a social media or social domain. And I'll give you an example. You use your debit card, credit card, PAN card everywhere, right? And you share with wherever you want to do share. But do you ever put your debit card number, credit card number, or PAN number, or your passport number on a social media, or Twitter or Facebook? So we have issued a detailed FAQ just few days back, and we have said that in case of an Aadhaar, Aadhaar has to be used very freely. You can give Aadhaar, your Aadhaar card to everyone. And you can rest assured that, nobody will be able to misuse your Aadhaar number, even if you know your Aadhaar number. Because Aadhaar number, if it is to be used for proving your identity, your fingerprint is required. Now, as we discussed just now, your face also will be required after some time, right? So it is, so your usage of Aadhaar number is not possible unless until it is accompanied by a fingerprint or OTP and face and iris and so and so. However, so far as the putting the Aadhaar number on the social media and other things are concerned, these are completely unnecessary, because credit card when you use, your debit card when you use your debit card, credit card with OTP and your signatures and other things, right? Correct. But still you don't put your debit card, credit card details on the internet.
So shifting focus just very quickly, it's today is the exact 1 year anniversary of the Supreme Court coming out and holding that privacy is a fundamental right. Now we have the Supreme Court declaring privacy to be a fundamental right, but we're still working. It is a work in progress. We still do not have a legal framework in place, which raises some concerns. Just a word from you, as far as 1 year journey is concerned, we still do not quite have a framework for enforcement of that right or for claiming responsibility from data fiduciaries.
So let me remind you that this whole privacy case judgment, which 1 year today we are, this is the first anniversary. Now this case arose from this Aadhaar case. And so while this whole Aadhaar issue was being debated in the Supreme Court during the last about 5-6 years, during this time the Parliament brought in Aadhaar Act. And when the Aadhaar Act was brought in, so Aadhaar Act was brought in with the presumption that the privacy is a fundamental right, right? And this act was passed in 2016. And 2017, Supreme Court Constitution Bench, 9-judge bench, did declare privacy as a fundamental right, which, you know, the Parliament, while passing the Aadhaar Act, had already, accepted that privacy is a fundamental right. And accordingly, all those privacy protection measures were incorporated in the Aadhaar Act itself. Now, so far as the question of general privacy is concerned, because privacy is a right, which is there in Aadhaar, as also is in a non-Aadhaar, for example, non-Aadhaar domain also. For example, when you open a bank account, or when you give your personal information to social media, for example, or you give your personal information to some other service providers, right? You may not have used Aadhaar, but still you have given all your personal details there. Now, the question was that whether those personal details also form the part of a fundamental right. And then the Supreme Court has, given a clear-cut verdict last year that the privacy is a fundamental right, and therefore the privacy has to be protected, just like any other fundamental right. Now, in order to achieve that objective, the government had constituted Justice Sri Krishna's committee, and that the Justice Sri Krishna's committee has just about 2 weeks back has given a rather, in fact, almost about a month back, has given a report, and in that report it has given a very, very detailed recommendations, and also a draft bill, and which the government and then the whole bill is before the government.
You feel the government should move on a war footing, perhaps, now that we have the bill and the recommendations?
So in fact, as far as I understand, the government has already started moving things. Government has put this whole bill in the public domain and has invited comments and suggestions, because this is going to be a very, very thorough legislative exercise. recognized by the parliament. And therefore, this whole data protection bill, which has been recommended by Justice Sri Krishna committee, there these people feedback, people's views, comments are being obtained by the Ministry of Information Technology. And based on those feedbacks, the process will be taken further, the cabinet approval, then the parliamentary approval, and then finally we will have a Data Protection Act.